Michael Philip Mimbs. Mike to his friends, Mikey to his wife, was born in Lakeland, Florida on December 22, 1953. He came into this world weighing a whopping 3 pounds. Mike was born to Cephas and Phyllis Mimbs. He was the middle brother. Corey was his older brother, and Kevin was his younger brother. Both were his lifelong best friends. Mike married Kathy on February 1st, 1975, and became Timmy's father on that very same day. Mike said from the beginning that it was a package deal, and when Kathy asked him if he was sure he wanted to take on that much responsibility, his response, in typical Mike fashion, was, "Kathy, how do you know I would marry you if you didn't have Timmy?" In June of the next year, Daddy's little girl arrived, and life was never the same. Jennifer completed the family and quickly displayed many of her dad's character traits. The happy family that started in a single wide trailer with no skirting in Thanona Sassa moved to a house in the big town of Zephyr, Florida. Mike was so proud of his first house with its pool and a satellite dish. It was at 812 Chadsworth Avenue that the family met their next-door neighbors and lifelong friends, Don and Christine. During this time, Mike worked his way up at Winn-Dixie, where he started his career at 16 bagging groceries. Mike managed several meat departments throughout the area. He then became a store manager in Brandon. He prided himself on clean floors and a full meat case. Somehow, Mike still found the time to be actively involved in coaching many of Timmy and Jen's athletic teams. He loved all kids, and kids loved him. Mike coached softball and football. His football coaching started at the Brandon Steelers, and then the Brandon Bears, which he and Kathy and three other couples founded in 1988, each contributing only $20. Many people doubted that the Bears could succeed. The one thing these detractors didn't factor in was the fundraising machine named Mike Mimbs. Profits from his golf tournaments and concession stands provided the initial funding for a successful league that is entering its 25th season this year, 2012. During these years, the family's next move was to Bloomingdale, where Mike spent the remainder of his life. It was during this time that two precious angels entered Mike's life, Jake and Ella, the two most beautiful, smartest, and all-around perfect people he had ever seen. As much as he loved being a father, it paled in comparison to being a pop. In looking back over Mike's life, it's hard to imagine that he ever realized the impact that he made on the people around him, many of which are here to honor him today. True to his nature, Mike spent just last Friday helping yet another teenager get their first job. This time, it was a neighborhood boy named Parker. When we think of Mike in the future, remember a kind-hearted man with a big smile and mischievous eyes who was always the life of the party and loved to make people laugh. He loved his mom, Corey, Kevin, Timmy, Jen, Jake, Ella, his nephews, and the rest of his family and friends, and especially his wife of 37 years, Kathy. We love you, Mike. Thank you for being a wonderful son, brother, husband, father, uncle, friend, and most importantly, the best pop ever. We will miss you.